Hey everybody, it's Nitya and welcome back to another video. So then, I was reading this. This is Monster Hunter for the PSP. I don't have my PSP yet. Gonna go ahead and close this. Guess what I got today? Oh, oops, it's actually broken. What the heck? Really? Oh no, it's not. Whatever, forget this. Alright. Guess what I got today? This thing right here, this is I don't know, something from eBay. My recorder's right next to me again over here, because I'm actually gonna do a sort of tutorial. Now I come back from my studio and I actually realized that I just got this, a new PS Vita. Just kidding, I've got this. This is the protective skin sticker thing for my PlayStation Vita 2000. Yes, 2000 right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply this now. Before I get started, I have no idea how to do this. I mean, I do know how to do it, but I've just never done this before, so I'm not gonna be good at it. All right I'm probably gonna have 1,000 tries before I get it on or whatnot, but it looks nice. That's the reason I got it. I'm just gonna pull this out. Enough to worry about the tapes. Anyway, so this is a vinyl sticker, so I don't know how you pronounce that, but whatever. So then this is made by Preserez something skin, and over here it says that it's easy to put, easy to remove, and no residue, which is good, because we don't want no residue, right? This is gonna be a long video, I guess, because I'm actually, whoa, look at this, that looks pretty cool. Because I've actually never done this, I have a feeling it's gonna be a long video. There's gonna be a lot of noise in the background because I'm not at my studio again, but I'm not really bothered. I'm just gonna go ahead and time lapse it a little bit, so you don't have to worry about the noise in the background. And while my other video is on rendering and all that, I'm actually going to go ahead and take this out if I can, and hopefully I don't destroy it, because I end up destroying a lot of my stuff. Now I don't know if it's supposed to sort of open up in a different way, but here we go. That's right there, and it's also, I think it's got a screen protector for it. Oh no, it's just a freaking plastic bag for it. Put this away. Right. This is my skin that I got for my Vita. It looks sort of the beautiful kind of thing. So I went ahead and got it. I'm not really kind of a guy that gets stickers to do with games and everything, so I went for this one. Now, it looks sort of, I mean, it feels good. And this thing is gonna have you on like this, and I'm actually not in a very nice position, and I've got stabilization. What a joke, I forgot to turn it off, didn't I? I think, yeah, whatever. I'm gonna go ahead and have to turn it off then, but I'm gonna go ahead and turn this thing. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah, actually, yeah, it does have it. This is the front bit. Now, it's really, really hard to actually put this on. Wait a minute, what the heck? Oh, I'm supposed to take that off. Oh, it's actually got the PlayStation Vita logo. I was, oh, thank God, right. I really don't want the PlayStation Vita logo disappeared. And no, it doesn't have Sony there, so that's a little naughty little thing. I don't really, you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and apply it. But what I'm gonna do is, I don't know if yeah, cleared it for the front, but as you can see, I'm gonna do this like a sort of like a live kind of thing. So, yeah, it's not like gonna be a professional with the voiceover and all the puns and all that kind of stuff, just to make it look like it's alright. It's got a nice little thing. I'm not gonna focus on it, I got no time for this. So you can like, yep, so you can actually apply this with a little bit of ease. Now, first of all, when you get these, what you wanna do is take out all the bits that you don't want to put on. So for the example, this was going to cover the screen, so this is not going to cover the screen now because I've took it off. this is going to go on this thing right here. No, that's actually a screen. No, I don't know if it's a screen protector. Where is it going? Oh, here it is, right. I'm going to put it on this thing because, yeah, you're right. It's actually easy to put on, easy to remove and everything. Okay, really good company so far. I never actually bought anything from these guys until now, I guess, because they make skins, okay? I don't buy skins. Now, it does sort of have little buttons. You're going to want to take them off before you actually apply the thing. So, just to let you know, there you go, a little one right there. Right, what I'm going to do is go ahead and skip here a little bit and I'll be back after I've actually taken all these off. It'll be better if I do that. Alright, so I've done it to the front. I'm just going to focus on it. As you can see, I took the D-pad bit off the over here. I forgot the speaker bit right there. I think, yeah, it's right over there. I'm going to go ahead and, you know, this big nail actually helps. Stupid little nail. It's really, really sharp as well. Don't mess with me. I think I messed up a little bit. Not really sure, but the bones taken off, the camera bit taken off, thumbstick, speaker, grill, and the star and step bone, whatever. So the front bit is done. I'm gonna go ahead and put that onto the side. Now, I've heard that when you apply on the back, it doesn't, apply over the touchpad at the back, it doesn't really, makes it, you know, so you can't use the touchpad, you can't. So you don't need to worry about that. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the back, because it doesn't actually have it for the L&R buttons and everything, not from the sides. That is a little funny. What is this, some kind of a joke? Because, okay, that's not nice. It doesn't have it for the L&R buttons, but it does have it for the rest of the damn thing. So it doesn't like cover the whole of it, but it covers most of it. I'm gonna start with the back because it's a lot easier. And once again, I've never done this before. I'm probably gonna be so bad at it. I'm gonna like have it upside down and everything like that. It goes this way. So I'll go ahead and turn the stabilization off because it's a little annoying and I don't want my thumbsticks to get messed up. I have a feeling if I put it upside down, it's just gonna sort of mess you up or sort of. But anyways, I'll be back. Alright, I've gone ahead and turned the stabilization off. Now before you put it on, you might want to go ahead and clean it a little bit. But mine's already clean, as though it seems. I'm gonna go ahead and place a little bits first. Oh yeah, actually there are no little bits. I'm gonna have to place this. Now they've actually given me the little touch screen kind of thing that actually helps with the sticking on bit. And I'm actually gonna go ahead and focus. I'm not gonna pick you. I'm actually gonna do a time lapse. So yeah, I'll shut up and let's go. There you go, nice and soft. Okay, yeah, I think it's done. I think it was that way. There you go. Yeah, it is that way. Okay. Whoa, wait a minute. All right, I forgot a little bit more about this. Forgot about the camera bit. I'm actually there are little bits over here that I have to take out. So I'm gonna have to go ahead and take out the ones on the back. So yeah, gonna go ahead and skip these bits. Right, that tiny little bit over there for the microphone, that was over there, so that was a little bit of a joke to actually take out. The next thing is the camera. I don't know if I'm actually supposed to take it out in one way or the other, but I actually want it to go on like completely. So where's my stand? Right, I don't have my stand here. That's really funny. Right, what I'm gonna do is go ahead and put it on the camera first. You're not really supposed to put it on the camera, but I don't really use it. I'm actually gonna, because I don't want the black bit over there. I don't really want the black bit. I'm gonna go ahead and shift it a little bit so you can see better. Right there. Right, I don't want the black bit around. I mean, you're supposed to have it. You're not supposed to like sort of take it off, but I'm actually gonna go ahead and put this on the black bit because
it doesn't really look nice. It never does, even on phones or whatever. Gonna be a biggest video. Sort of afraid. Gonna take a long time to render this. I'll do this without the time lapse bit.
Without time lapsing it. So it was this way, and yeah, it was this way sort of. So you can see, it's it's sort of easier to put in, but it's sort of hard as well at the same time, if you know what I mean. No, alright, forget it. Right, that should be okay. You know, I really am sort of pissed off about these thumbsticks. It only did have to go with them sticking out. Should have gone with the like Nvidia shields, so you don't have to stick out and worry about it getting messed up and all sort of stuff like that. But this ring, I actually want even this little bit. Oh, this one's really, really tough actually. Shoot. This one's... Wait a minute. Is this supposed to go around it? Alright. I think it's supposed to go around the top and the sides and whatnot. I'm actually gonna sort of just take this one off. Because I don't think this one's supposed to be going on. But the rest... I'm gonna go ahead and move the recorder sort of out of the way. This is actually gonna take a very long time for me to put on because I'm sort of not in a good position as well. I can't really get around it. I'm gonna just do it, hope for the best, and let's just go with this big bit. I've never done this, that's why I'm so nervous and that kind of stuff. Okay, I've done the back, so it's all empty on the sticker area kind of thing, the, don't know what it's called. But as you can see, I've sort of done it, but it's sort of not perfect. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and, the white balance is like, kharab. I mean, it's not like perfect, it's not gonna focus, is it? Little joke, right. As you can see, it's not perfect, I've missed out some little areas, overlapped some bits, but you know, it's for the first time and it's really, really hard for first timers in sort of doing everything, I guess. I think I'm actually quite happy with the way it is right now. As you can see, this little bit over here is also covered. The microphone is sort of messed off. But that, this one I think is sort of almost perfectly applied, the one on the top. The camera bit was the easiest, I mean, doing this little bit because it just matched perfectly and easily with the camera. But this bit was sort of like a pain, and this big bit here was the worst one because it took me, you know, because I could actually align these perfectly, but then this was wrong. So whatever. Anyways, gonna go ahead and go to the front now. I'm actually gonna go ahead and sort of clean this up with my windshield over here. I guess that's the only thing I have around here. So yeah, oops, so I sort of messed it up, I think. I might actually have to take off my, I don't know if I'm actually supposed to be applying it to the thumbstick, but I didn't because I'm going to keep it on these on anyways. Now the only thing I don't know about is whether the back part touchpad actually works, because they don't have a co-out for this, so I'm assuming it will work. I'll go ahead and turn in. As you can see, the PS logo is sort of sticking over there, I mean over there, but anyways, I'm gonna see if I can apply the front bit, because this bit is just like a one big piece that goes on, and I don't want to hide the bones, so I've actually took it off. I don't know if it's supposed to keep them on, but the front bit is the hardest. And here it comes, and I'm gonna wish me good luck. This thing has actually been a lot of help. I don't know if you've been seeing me just doing this, just do the little bits around, just little tiny parts to kin and whatnot. Anyways, let's go ahead and time lapse this again, and I'm gonna go ahead and apply the one on the front. Now it's gonna be really, really tough, so it's probably gonna be an hour video or something. Hopefully it doesn't have to be, but yeah, wish me good luck. I'm going, and I might actually want to change the view on this camera before I actually do this, sort of up and down like that. That will be good enough, I guess. So yeah, let's go ahead and shift myself around. All right, wish me good luck. I'm gonna go ahead and apply this, because I mean, it does come off and there is no residue, which is good. But I don't know if the sticky, the sticky glue bit, just is probably gonna start, how you can say, it's gonna dry out. I have a feeling is if I take way too long for it to just do it, it's probably gonna dry out. So I'm gonna have to do it as quick as I can. I'm gonna go ahead and focus on this thing properly again. There we go, hopefully that is focused. So yeah, I wish me good luck, and I mean, for the big part, which is the most hardest. It's the hardest part because there are so many little bits. If I mess up once, messed up the whole thing. Let's go. I'm gonna have to take these off. Oof, this Vita looks like naked now. Oh boy, it does feel good to use these sticks again without those. I have to take them off because these bits don't really fit without it. I'm gonna go ahead and do it again. So yeah, I'm gonna put them things back on though. Wish me good luck again. Alright, so I've actually got it on. It wasn't as hard as I thought, actually. It was soft, a lot easier than I thought. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that it doesn't cut off the screen. Now, about the top over here, I'm gonna go ahead and focus on it again if I can. Alright, there we go. It's almost done it because I've actually got it a little stretched out, sort of. But it doesn't cover the screen at all. It's, as you can see right at the edges and the corners. It sort of doesn't just cut you off. You can see the battery level, you can see the side icon and everything. It doesn't cut you off. It's pretty much good enough, I guess. Let me just go on this again, right? It wasn't as hard as I thought, but as you can see over here, it's not really perfectly aligned. And on this side, the speaker's not perfectly aligned, but the bones are okay. And as you can see, there's a little bit over there that's sort of popping up. And that's because this isn't perfectly aligned, but I'm going to actually leave that. Leave that the way it is. And yeah, so that's the front done, and it wasn't as hard as I thought. It's a little funny, as you can see on this side there's a little white gappy bit over there, but on this side it's not, because yeah, like I said, it's not perfectly aligned. But I think what I'm gonna do is, and the back's already done as well, I think what I'm going to do is sort of turn this off. I'm actually thinking that it's a good idea. I actually think it is a good idea to put it on the thumbsticks as well. I'm not really sure if it's supposed to, but I'm gonna go ahead and do it, see if I can, and because it would really look a lot better. I mean, so far the way it looks now, right now, is pretty cool. I like it. But gonna go ahead and see if I can actually see which way this goes. This way is this is a little funny. Right, I'll go ahead and see which way this thing goes. Another way, right? Right, I'll go ahead and put it on. Oh no, we're not supposed to put it in there. All right, whatever, forget it. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Where's my little things gone? There they are. Hello. Right, I'm gonna go ahead and put these back on. Which way did I have them? Right, this way. But yeah, I think it looks pretty cool. Now there is no screen protector. I don't think they have a screen protector with it. If it did, I mean, what the heck? Now, I don't think it's supposed to come with a screen protector. I didn't ask for it anyways, and it hasn't really come with it. So it's sort of this is going to be a pain to put these back on, because I don't know if you guys actually watched my video on these thumbstick cups. It was certainly one of the worst experiences, because anyways, I'll just skip it because that is not part of this video. So yeah, that's the skin on the oh wait, I actually forgot to check out if the back touch pad works. Right, I'll be back. Okay, while that turns on, as you can see, the side is not covered at all. I really think they should have actually provided some for the side. It would have looked a lot better, just to complement the rest of it. But they haven't really done that, so yeah, it's not really that is green. It looks white on the freaking camera, stupid little camera. But as you can see, it doesn't, it feels a lot better though, because it's like matte finished, not a glossy or anything like that. It's like all over the thing, it's like with the, you know, where it felt with the rest pads over here, it's like all over it now, so it looks better. I mean, feels better. But I think this bit over here looks a little naked now, because it's not covered with flowers, and it doesn't look all that. I mean, it looks naked now because the circle bit is gone for, you know, the circle bit that actually was around there is actually disappeared now. So yeah, it looks a little. But whatever, let's just turn this on. See if the touchpad works. No, I don't wanna. A little bit of gameplay of Borderlands here. It's gonna take a long time loading. I don't know why it's so slow. This PS Vita isn't really tough. Not the toughest system out there. Right, the PSP hasn't come yet, in case you guys are wondering. This actually came from all the way from Hong Kong, and it didn't take that long. They said it was gonna come next month, but I mean, from the beginning, since the beginning of this month, which is, I mean, the end of September, like after 25th of September, all the way to 25th of October. But it's actually come, and it's not that it's it's actually come a lot earlier than they actually told me, because normally when I order from Hong Kong, things take a lot longer to come. Okay, and I mean like a lot longer. Just worry that it might either just keep pressing it itself because it senses this vinyl on it, or yeah, so that's what I'm so worried about. It's gonna mess up the whole thing. I'm actually gonna have to take it off, and I don't really wanna. I might just cut it up. Or probably not, because I don't want to do that either. Right, let's go then. Right, well, seems like I can look around. Oh, by the way, that's a legendary gun, that. I don't, alright, let's see. Oh, it actually does work. Okay. Alright, it does work perfectly fine. In case you guys were just wondering, oh, it actually feels bad without those stupid thumbstick things on now. But as you can see, it doesn't cover the screen. Everything's okay. It works perfectly fine. I touch the back panel and it starts running. You guys can look at the screen if you are, I don't know if you, there we go, pushing the back, and no, I'm not pressing any buttons, I'm just looking, okay, I really want the thumb stick bits on now, because it just doesn't feel nice anymore. But anyway, Borderlands, get lost, don't want to play it anymore. So yeah, that's how we, that's my sort of application kind of, oh, look at this, it looks disgusting at the sides. It doesn't really cover up all of it. I don't really like that. I mean, they didn't come with any other stickers other than the front and the back. I'm pretty sure they didn't. No, it didn't come with anything else. That's all it came with. It just came with that. I think they actually 3D printed or something, laser cut it or something. And it's pretty cool actually, like this. Oh, wait, I'm not playing the game. What the heck are we doing? Anyway, so that's been my video on applying a vinyl skin on the PlayStation Vita. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, go ahead and give a thumbs up. If you have any comments, oh, flip, I've actually messed it up. Let me know in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one, which is probably a let's play video. Yeah, I'm going.